Hello, it's the 1st of March. I haven't even edited the February vlog yet, which is weird to start the first clip of March, but here I am. It's the 1st of March. I'm doing another post office run with a bag of some Etsy orders, which is exciting. Do I have a mask? Yes, I do. It's 9:30 in the morning. It's a very foggy, misty day. Yeah, there's talk of schools going back soon, which is a bit worrying. There's talk of lockdown easing, which is very worrying. I had originally planned to go back to Canada this month, but that is not happening. Probably will be the summer now, which is fine. But yeah, it's March. That means we are 3 weeks away from... I just got in someone's way. someone was running with their dog. Means we're 3 weeks away from daylight savings or the clocks going forward, which is the most exciting time of the year. I think, yeah, so I'm just doing a post office run and maybe get a coffee. I'm up early enough for the coffee shop to be open. They're so nice in there. I keep stopping recording when people walk past because it is a bit awkward. I can't really remember what I was going to say. Anyway, welcome to March. It's the 3rd of March. I tied my hair up because I washed it and it's gone all like fluffy. So I've tied it up and it looks kind of funny. Oh my god, it's so beautiful. This is the banner I commissioned. Here it is. Oh, it's just so beautiful. I love it so much. It makes me so emotional. Oh, look at it. So good. I'm so glad that I commissioned it because it's going to be with me for hopefully ever. It's the 3rd of March. Today I watched the Britney Spears documentary. I finished off weaving. I put some on Etsy and I'm just started a new weaving. I also did the homework for the Andrew Gibson writing workshop this morning, and I uploaded it and I got some really lovely feedback from Andrea, which is really nice. It was a very vulnerable piece of writing, so it kind of feels weird Andrea having read that, but it's also kind of comforting at the same time. I'm also in the stage of like really wanting to cut my hair, like really wanting to shave it all off. So I'm having to kind of really fight the urge because I'm feeling not super great about myself. But, yeah, so that's what's going on with that. It is growing. It's just in that really not super great stage. And it hasn't been cut, so there's like no structure to it. I'm just letting it do its thing and it doesn't feel super great, but I've just got to keep going. A few people have said you just have to keep going with the grow out, so that's what I'm doing. If I don't like it, I can always cut it off, but I've got to the stage, well, not this long, but I've got to the stage where I want to cut it so many times, and I just have, so I'm gonna try and keep going with it. Just for the past week, just haven't been feeling super great. Just been very tired. My sleep isn't good. I'm really not sleeping well. But I'm just really tired, really sad. Just not having a great time. But the rest of the family are doing pretty similarly in terms of their mental state, and that's kind of comforting, but also it's kind of just like, oh, when is this gonna end? We're still in lockdown. And there's talk about lockdown kind of easing or changing in, you know, and I don't know whether the schools are going back at some point, but it's all a little bit anxiety inducing, because even though lockdown is like really hard, going back to some normality and then having to go back to another lockdown is equally really stressful. Oh, but my commission banner is so beautiful. It's the 4th of March. I'm wearing my pajamas still. It's like 2 p.m. Been in a bit of a creative lull today, so I'm making a lemon drizzle cake. I'm on my second cup of coffee. Got to put some sugar in there. I'm watching The Act, which is, I'm only on the first episode, but it's super interesting. Also listening to a really crappy lesbian romance novel book on Audible, just because I wanted something gay to listen to. And what else? I ordered a couple of books on Amazon yesterday. I ordered My Year of Rest and Relaxation because I've heard a lot about it, and it got talked about a lot in my writing workshop, and I was like, I want to read this book, and I wanted to read it, not listen to it for some reason, so I got that. And I also got Notes on Camp by Susan Sontag, because I've always wanted to own a copy of that. And I'm just gonna make this cake now, and then I'm working on a rug for my bedside table. Hello, it's the 6th of March, I believe. It's a it's a Saturday. I just said goodbye to Mark and Anna, who are going to get their COVID vaccine. They have to go back to West Sussex to get it, so they are doing that, which is cool. I'm just sitting here with a coffee. I got into the habit of putting a chocolate oat milk in my coffee. And it's like a dessert. It's delicious. I feel like such a bad vlogger. I don't want to be called a vlogger. I won't refer to myself like that ever again. Oh my god. Also, this month marks the start of year 6 of the vlogs, which means that I have 5 years of my life online, which is kind of cool. I really like doing it, and it's like nice to see me progress, and my memory's not super great, so watching the vlogs back is really nice. I'm really grateful to my past self for doing it, and for my current self for still doing it. Even though I feel like the vlogs are really boring at the moment, because it is just me like sitting in front of my phone just
kind of whining about stuff, but this is what it is, and you know, it's hard right now, and yeah. Anyway, I don't know what I'm gonna do today. Might have a bath. Might have a morning bath. It is week 3 of the Andrew Gibson workshop. This is my messy bed again. I'm really trying to get into the process of making my bed every day, but it is hard right now. That is okay. I have logged into this workshop and I've got my weaving that I'm working on down here, which I'll finish off this evening, hopefully. Yeah, here we go.
It is such an addition to my life in this time where I'm hardly, you know, basically never leaving the house. So thank you so much for that. this week, I'm really excited about this week. This week is The Stars in Your Dark Side, Poems That Flip Our Perspectives, and How to Write While Standing on Your Head, which I've never done. Probably most of us cannot actually do that. But if you can, please send us a video and don't hurt yourself in the process. We're going to take lots of different angles in regards to flipping our perspective today.
I wonder if I make you a co-host, would that be allowed?
I think so. Then it would work, probably, but otherwise right now I cannot share any music.
It's the 8th of March. You probably can't hear me because the kids are playing, but I'm going on a food shop run. I'm making dinner for the family tonight, which I'm actually looking forward to because it's something to do, isn't it? Getting a bit stir crazy now, but hopefully I'll be able to drive soon. That would make a difference, but it's actually quite nice walking, considering I'm not moving my body around a lot, but yeah, going to the food shop. Hello. It's Friday evening. It's the 12th of March today. I haven't filmed anything for a couple of days, but it's the 12th of March today, which means that it's officially been 1 year since the start of the pandemic. The 12th of May 2020 was the year that myself and my ex-partner decided to start quarantining or self-isolating in our flat in London. And it was the last time that I saw I went over to a friend's house, and it was just such a weird time, but I really remember the date. Dinner's ready. Okay, it's the next day because I had dinner with the family, and then I had a film club, which is what me, Luke, Isabel and Oliver do on a Friday evening, and it was really good, so I forgot to finish what I was talking about in the vlog, but I think I was talking about how the 12th of March marked a year of kind of everything changing due to the coronavirus pandemic or the COVID-19 pandemic. The only good thing is that a year later is that the UK is rolling out vaccinations at a exponential rate, or as fast as they can. I think the UK has the highest vaccinated population in Europe so far. So Mark and Anna got the vaccine, which is really cool. So yeah, I guess we just don't know what's gonna happen, but I don't think anyone thought a year later that we would be in the same place. But yeah, this morning I'm just working on my poetry manuscript. I've kind of collated a document of all the poetry that I've written, and I'm putting it all in one place. I'd really like to submit a manuscript once it's ready to be published as a chapbook. But I guess we'll see. I guess we don't know. But that's what I'm working on this morning. Hello. It's the 15th of March. Me and Anna are just doing an errand run, post office, and some other stuff in town. Yeah. Basically, I slept a lot this weekend. My sleep isn't very good still, but I'm trying not to worry about it, and hopefully it will just sort itself out. But yeah, we're just doing that, and then I have to do some admin for this magazine that I have joined the team of, which is exciting. I've become a writer contributor for a queer and queer ally magazine based in the UK. So I've got to do a bunch of stuff. Okay, Anna is back.
Maybe Beat Saber, but...
Will is showing me his new VR thing, so I'm going to film myself.
But I'm tangling. We've been playing it.
Trying it out.
Yeah, you look so stupid from the outside.
Okay, bye bye, and I go. Whoa!
Wait, I might need to change the sound. I don't think the sound's on. Wait, hold on, I need to. So if you use these thumbsticks.
How do I do it again? Oh yeah. Oh my god. Ah! Oh my god, it feels like I'm on a ledge, my legs feel real! This is really scary. Hello, it's the 19th of March today. This is my unmade bed again, but I haven't been filming a lot. Last night, me and Will played some VR, and that's about it. I've just been working on this weaving project, where I'm weaving small wall hangings, all within like, I feel like you can't see me, all within like food related text things, because I want to donate 100% of the proceeds, 50-50 between Unity Kitchens Toronto, this organisation that provides free meals for downtown Toronto, and then also the other 50% will go to Queer Food Project Manchester, which is an organisation providing free meals to queer people in the Greater Manchester area in the UK. But yeah, I'm doing things like this, Food for All, and Spoonful of Seconds. This one says, I eat, you eat, we eat. And then this one says, I could eat you up. I'm very excited about them, they're very sweet. I've just warped up my loom to get started on the fifth one. I did just impulsively buy a large loom, which is, I've been very depressed all week, and I have felt happiness for the first time, and I feel like I could cry about it because I'm so excited. I'll be able to make things that are like bath mat size, so I could make a bath mat size rug. It's the same people who made my medium size loom, so I trust its kind of design and structure. And it's the cheapest, largest loom that I've seen on online. And it was free delivery, and I was like, this is a sign from the universe to buy it. So I did. So I'm very excited about that. That is a very exciting. Very exciting to look forward to. So yeah, I'm basically all I'm doing is I'm watching all of Modern Family whilst weaving, trying to get this series done so I can get hopefully put them on sale and get money to these organisations that are doing really cool things. Today, me and Anna are going out to Tesco's. I think I might have film club tonight. I'm also watching the release of this dance film that's made by, or not made by, that one of Oliver's friends in Toronto was involved in. Yeah, and that's it, really. That's what I'm doing. Hello, it's the 20... the sky! Look at this! Wow! Oh my goodness! Wow, oh my goodness, the sky is lovely. My bed is unmade again. Yep. It's the 21st of March. It's like 6:30, but it feels like 10:30 p.m. I just have finished another life drawing session, so I drew this, which I'm quite proud of actually. And then I can get the pages. I also did this page, and I also did this page, with these little feet, which I found the feet quite funny. I also made this rug sample today, because I ordered a large loom. I don't know if I've told the vlog or not, but I'm gonna make bath mat size rugs. So I made a sample of what I want to make for my bedroom, except I don't have the colours. I did a big yarn order today of this type of yarn, but there's something like quite comforting about kind of the feel of it and how it's, I've made this like piece of fabric almost. I really like it. I'm gonna try again, but instead of, if you can see, I've used quite thick warp, which is the, this white string that keeps it together. I'm going to try with a thinner one and see how that goes, because it's my first time tying it off at the back, so it has no fringe, and I think the thicker warp distorts the edging. So I am going to try again. Hello, it's like the 23rd of March. I haven't been filming a lot because I've been sleeping a lot, and weaving, and that's basically what I've been doing since the beginning of the year. Yeah, today a yarn order came in where I got this dark grey, this mustard, this lighter grey, this light blue, this white, and then I got this big 500 gram cone of dark teal, because dark teal is one of my favourite colours. Hello, it's the 28th of March, it's a Sunday. I am just sitting at the kitchen table with a coffee, and I'm working on this weaving, and I'm, it's the Toronto Queer Film Festival this week. It started on Thursday at like 6 p.m, so must have been like 11 p.m. UK time, so I've just started to catch up on what I've missed so far.
It matters versus. Like myself, TQFF will exist exclusively online this year. To check out screens you might have missed, or the schedule for our upcoming symposium.
This is our first friendship event with Right Bloody UK up in Narnia, and Right Bloody North up in Canada, and it's a long time overdue that we're like, hey, let's do something together with some of our superstars. And
my eyes, so committed they were to never falling for the joke of astonishment. When I was told there were seven wonders of the world, I trusted the math.